Hello and welcome to the live stream of CGTN. I'm reporter Zheng Yibing, now at the Baicheng County in southern Xinjiang. This place used to be a part of the ancient Qiuzi state. Just take a look at the distant place. This is really the amazing place, and we can see the Chueletage Mountain. I'll explain the surrounding areas first. Looking to the distance, there is a very barren land. This mountain is rugged and reddish under the blue sky and the sunset. It looks beautiful, but it's barren land. Take a look at the closer place. There is an oasis, the green trees and rivers and ponds, and even the reservoir. It looks really beautiful. It is in this place, back to the 1,000 years ago. It used to be the part of the Qiuzi state, where the ancient art of local people once flourished for at least 800 years. And now we come back here to this castle, the cave temple and remains of the Buddhism artistic creation. And take a look at this beautiful scenery here. And now in China, there are a lot of the caves or the grottos. For example, in Gansu province, in northwestern China, there is a Mongol grottos. And in Hunan province, in Shanxi province, there are also Longmen and Yungang. They are very, very famous. But here in southern Xinjiang, there's one which is also famous, not only because of its paintings, murals, and caves, Buddhist remains, but also it is a current recorded, the earliest excavated Buddhist caves here in China. So joining me now is a researcher, chief researcher, Mr. Miao Lihui here. He's based here in the Kucha Institute of Xinjiang, studying here for over 23 years. 老师你好。
很高兴接受我们的采访啊！首先，我们在来到这个克孜尔千佛洞之后呢，都被这个很高大的山岩，还有这个洞窟，还有壁画给震撼了。所以，我们先请您简单的介绍一下克孜尔千佛洞它有什么样一些特点，好吗？好。So
general introduction by Mr. Miao Lihui, chief researcher here at a researcher here in the Kizil Academy of the Xinjiang. So let him explain.
您简介了，实际介绍一下。好的，好的。我们就先从眼前这种洞窟开始介绍吧。这种洞窟呢，我们把它叫做大象窟，就是我们正对的这一面呢，原来有一个非常高大的一个佛像，近15米。这个窟的年代呢是公元40世纪。然后我们还有看到两侧呢有很多这个方槽，方槽里原来插了有木头，木头上有一个平板，平板上呢又是立像，所以我们可以想见当时呢。 这个两侧也是密密麻麻的佛像。Well,
very good introduction at the start of our tour. So let me explain. When we got to the entrance of this cave, the first cave, the biggest cave in Kizil, the cave temple here, this is a place where used to stand very big Buddha statue. It is about 15 meters tall from the ground here to that level, to the top. And there are also 5 layers of the holes here. And Mr. Miao Lihui told us there used to stand a very small the Buddha statues in each of them. Very, very impressive. And also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At the top of the entrance to this cave, there are some kind of remains, there were even paintings.
那么老师,我们看到在这个入口处的最顶端啊,有一些这个
像是壁画的遗迹啊，你能给我们介绍一下那里是什么？Could you explain to us the top of this cave entrance?
应该是飞天。就是这也是在佛教艺术里非常有名的一类壁画内容。它实际上呢，就是在佛教所有的一些重要的事件，比如说佛的说法、诞生、涅槃，都会出现飞天。
So although these paintings, these images are very vague now, we know their name is apsaras. Usually they appear in the paintings, in the murals of grottos or the cave temples. Their existence is to show the atmosphere of that of certain religious activity or the scenes. Back to the current time. 那我们还可以注意到，那么现在在这个地方呢，原来应该是有很大很大的一个佛像哦。
对对对。
那么在什么时间段里边，这个佛像可能存在过？就什么时候它会消失呢？So it's supposed to be a very big Buddha statue here, but when did it begin to exist and when did it diminish from this world?
从目前我们的研究来看呢，就是公元四世纪的时候，这个佛像应该就已经建立了。应该是在公元的十三世纪吧。随着这个地区的宗教变迁，文化上的一个变化，这里的这个塑像呢，肯定就被毁坏了。
Wow, it's like this. There used to be the big Buddha statue here.It's almost 10 meters tall, but it came into exist in 4th century AD. But after 9 centuries, 100 years later, because of the change of religious belief here, and due to the natural changes, disasters, or even the on-purpose destruction, the statue disappeared. So that is really a pity.非常可惜。袁老师，我们现在想进到这个洞窟里边，您给我们看一下非常震撼的这个壁画吧。
好的，好的，
好。So follow Mr. Miao to enter this cave to see the paintings, the murals inside. So please be careful. And this road is very narrow. The door.And inside this cave is quite dark.Please be careful. Just come inside. 慢慢进来啊。袁老师，我有个问题啊。一般我们到洞穴里边、洞窟里边去看壁画的时候，都通常会出一种保护的目的啊，尽量的减少这种光线的存在。
对。
那么今天，你能够介绍一下，就是什么样情况下才可以用光？这种光一定要注意什么？
当然，我们是说呢，原则上就是出于保护研究。这样的目的你可以用，当然为了弘扬，我们就是宣传它啊，也可以用。只不过呢，对光源有特殊的要求，比如它使用冷光源。
Okay, let me explain. So when we enter this cave, there are some kind of the prohibitions or regulation or rules. For example, like using the light, because everybody knows the painted murals, they're scared of the light. So there's special purpose for research or publicity of these paintings, these murals. Certain kind of light is allowed. For example, the light we're using now is a cold source of light. Okay.
那您可以给我介绍一下，接着我们在这个洞窟里面能看到什么样的一些景象，让我们的观众来欣赏一下。
好的。
So we explain to our audience what's inside on the wall of this cave.
好的。
我们介绍一下。
好的，好的，好的。您看啊，就是我们见到的这个，我们身边看到这个啊，这个原来是有一身大卧佛的啊。然后呢，它也后面呢，我们看上面还有些飞天。这个整个呢，它实际上是我们叫素慧结合，它其实表现的是一个佛教的故事，就是佛的涅槃。嗯。
So this cave, this big cave, is indicating the story that is the passing away of the Buddha, the Sakyamuni.This is a story starting from this place. On the top of this cave, 那我们可以看到在这个顶端啊 on the top of this cave, there are certain kind of the images, the apsaras, the flying in the sky, showing this is important religious activity or this kind of event. A little bit lower, 我们可以往下镜头拉一点点。So there are certain kind of the belts. There are small images of the Buddhas.
我们可以看到这个地方的话，其实是有一些很小的一些这个佛像的。
对对。
接着往下走的话，是一个很大的平台。And lower part, 在底下的位置呢
，the lower part we can see the platform. There used to be a statue here, either. Mr. Miao said this is about a story that passing away of the Buddha, the Sakyamuni.When he sleeping here is about to enter another sphere, and all his apprentices, all his the monks, the Buddhism monks came here to worship him to see this important event, important moment. That's the biggest part about this cave.
那可以继续我们再看一下还有什么样的一些细节给我们做一介绍。
可以。
So what about the other details of the murals here?
我们可以看看这个画面很有意思的。我们看到这个。
Interesting. This is a big part of the mural. I see there are three people, three Buddhist monks.
是不是这地方有三个比丘？这个比丘呢，它是你看是个鞋子，似乎在飞行。另外呢，我们可以看它的肩上呢，既有这种火焰的形状，也有水波的纹样。OK， 这就是在佛教说呢，就是它施展神通，从印度各地赶来。
Okay, so we know that the Buddhism originates from India, ancient India, one of the four ancient civilizations. So we told all the audiences what is about this place, and even the sleeping statue of a Sakyamuni and those fly images. And here, there were three Buddhist monks that flying in the sky, showing that moment. They're flying from different parts of the ancient India to the Sakyamuni to say goodbye to their master before he passes away from this world. That is the way these paintings, these murals are showing. And we can see, 我们可以看到在那个三个佛像的那个佛像那个造像的那个肩膀的位置啊，有这个淡淡的绿色。 像火焰一般，we can see the green flames on the shoulder of three Buddhist monks. That is the wings because they're flying. It shows that. 好，明老师，这个佛洞里边的那个主要的一些细节就是这样子吗？差不多。好，您带我们去另外一个去看一下啊，还有一些什么样的一些特别之处。So we will follow you to another cave in Kizil. Be careful. 先停一下啊，先暂缓一下。Ladies and gentlemen, we are doing the live streaming in Kizil Cave Temple in Baicheng County in southern Xinjiang. Joining me now is Mr. Miao Lihui, chief researcher of the curator Academy of Xinjiang. We're talking about the very big cave in Kizil, the cave temple here. Just a moment ago, we saw the images or the paintings, all the scriptures inside the wall of this cave. Now we're going heading towards another one to see very different images or sculptures. So I'll follow you.
梁老师，我们在科萨尔这个地方啊，大概有多少个佛窟呢？就我们现在的编号呢，有349个。So
there are altogether 349 caves in Kizil Cave Temple here.
是。那么这样的一些
佛窟呢？他们最早是开凿于什么什么那个时代呢？又是在什么时候慢慢的就是淡出人们的视线呢？So when did they begin to exist, and when they diminished from this world?
大概在公元三世纪的时候，这里就开始开凿洞窟了。八世纪中叶以后，逐渐就废弃了。
Oh, well, that's really a long history. The back to the three century A.D. These caves began to came into being after almost five centuries,
500多年以后，
almost 600 years later, after the change of time, change of belief in this region, these caves just decayed and flourished into that time and became the current images. Now we enter another cave to see more details.
Okay.
The structure here is very similar with number 47 cave. This is number 48, one of the 349 caves in Kizil, the cave temple complex here in Baicheng County. Let's follow me. So be careful. This is an area. Okay, come inside. This is quite different from the previous cave. And more details, clearer images. So Mr. Miao, please tell us more details about here.
好的。So
what is this special about this cave? What's the difference between it with the previous one?
这个呢，我们可以看到它的顶部呢保存得非常好。
One of the distinctive features about this cave is
Its ceiling, unlike others, is preserved very well. So what's on the surface of the ceiling? Let me ask.
Okay.
都是关于什么的呢？
还是我们前面呢，在前面四十七窟也讲到了飞天，嗯，但是这个窟呢，我们看到保存的更完整一点，嗯，我们可以发现呢，关于飞天的一些更细、更多的细节。
Oh, so the quite similar with the apsaras on the ceiling of K47, is in K48. There are more details. Please explain.
比如说我们看呢，其实飞天是分男女的。
Oh.
我们往那边看，那面是一身女性飞天。
So Mr. Miao said the apsaras could be divided according to their gender. They're male and also female. For example, this one is a female apsaras. So why that is a she apsaras?
为什么她是一个女性呢？
我们可以看呢，她穿有胸衣啊。
Because the clothing is quite different from others. She's wearing the suit, sort of like the women's suit.
那么她可以穿的是女性的那种服装啊。
对，是啊。然后我们再往这面看。
But other figures are quite different. For example, this part.
全部都赤裸上身的。
These three figures or others, they're naked. Only the half body, the top body, upper body is naked, so that indicates they are male. 好，我们继续来做介绍吧。
哎，好，就这个就反映出，其实就是这个，飞天呢，实际上它是在这个佛教里是属于这个，它是属于两类神，嗯，一个叫秦达婆，一个叫紧那罗。
哦，
他们常常是结为夫妻的。
Well, this is an explanation the first time I heard about. So the apsaras, they are divided into male and female. They could be called, the first name is,
第一个名叫什么呢？
钱大婆。
The first name is 钱大婆, and the second is
锦大罗.
So they are divided into different genders. They could get married. So that is according to the story, according to the records of the Buddhist stories, right? 它就是佛教里面确实是这样记载的。
是是是是。
So that is true according to Buddhism. 好，还有一些什么样的细节给我们展示呢？
还有一个呢，我们如果说呢，就是我们去过敦煌，
嗯，
大家会发现这里的飞天和敦煌的飞天呢，是风格上是完全不一样的。
OK， 我们可以把那个镜头对向这个位置啊，就这边这尊飞天。So there's a big difference between the mirrors, the figures and mirrors between here in Kizil in southern Xinjiang and that of Dunhuang or the Mogao grottos in Gansu province, eastward of Xinjiang, Uygur Township region. That's the big difference. Could you explain what's the difference between these two kind of mirrors? Here and in Gansu province.
Okay, 我们看呢，就是这样的飞天呢，它比较写实，人物的形态呢，显得是比较那个健美。
嗯，
而且呢，它这个身姿呢，它的这个主要是靠这种飞行的状态，表明它在飞行。
嗯，
然后呢，如果我们去敦煌，你会看到呢，它那个人物呢，都显得比较清瘦。
啊，
另外呢，它的这个飘动呢，主要是通过这个衣服飘带的这个。摆动以及云气。
Okay, so let's get back to that figure. Let's get back to that one and let us explain. Let us see. 来看一下那个部分啊，就是我们的镜头转向就是最里边的那个飞天的形象。So Mr. Miao said about to this figure in the mirrors. It looks like the real human being.Like they have the muscle, they have the body. They don't have a lot of the. Don't look very seen like the Mogao grotto. So that's a big difference. So here, all the images on the murals they look like the real human being, unlike other parts of the country in China. So that's a big difference. Okay,
那这是这样的一个情况。对，我们也看到了，在这个台子上有一些这样的一些展示品啊。能给我们做一些介绍吗？哦，这个呢是我们这个为了就是，做这个对洞窟啊进行一些这个保护修复。所准备的一些材料。啊，这个呢有一个我们专门的保护所的工作人员孙文军，让他给大家做个介绍。
好了，苏老师您好。So let me introduce. This is the lady, Su Wenjun. He's a cultural protector here. And she would explain how people, researchers, protectors here are doing research and how to protect, preserve the ancient the murals on the surface of the wall.
你们来我们介绍一下，平常你们在做的一些保护工作，但是我们今天看到您准备了一些 展示品啊，我们就很好奇，让你来做个介绍。So
in front of us, there is a pad. There's as if this is a kind of painting. So let Miss Su to explain.
来，你们介绍一下。啊，这个是我们就是工作人员做的一个小型的，就是一个壁画，算是做的一个实验。然后下面这一层呢，它是一个支撑体，相当于我们这边一个就是这个墙上这个岩石一样，就是支撑体。因为壁画呢，它一般是由三部分构成。
Hold on for a second. Let me explain to our audience and let us doing it one by one. So Miss Su is holding the pad, sort of like the fresco, sort of that like the murals. On the base, it is a pad, and then this layer is sort of like the rock, because this cave is excavated in the cliff of Mingwutaga Mountain. So all the paintings are based on the rocks. This is the first step. And then when the art creators, they try to paint the murals, the first one, they would put the first layer of mud, and then the second layer, the third layer, am I right?
我说的不知道是不是这个是你想表达的一个意思啊？你给我们能细说一下吗？第三层啊。好，这个呢就是第一层是个支撑体，然后这个是呢第二层，就是一二三，这三个呢都是属于第二层的，是一个那个地障层。哦，对，因为地障层呢，它不可能在制作过程中不可能说只抹一遍泥，就是那个泥，它会呢抹到两到三层的泥，然后做成这个支撑那个地障层。然后最上最最最上面一层呢，我们看到就是我们现在就是还没有完成的，就是它是一个颜料层，是一个基础层用来绘画的。
Okay, let me explain. So this is just like I explained. This the first one is the supporting section, supporting structure, sort of like the rock. And then before painting on the art in the ancient town of Chuzi State, they would put the mud, the first layer, the second layer, even the third layer. And until that moment, they would put the kind of the a smooth surface here, and then begins painting itself.
好，你们继续我们介绍吧。好，就是我们看到我们现在是起了一个线稿，就是没有像进行那个把颜料没有往上涂。现在呢，我们可以看到这边呢，就是有先放这。OK。 我们看到我们这边呢放了四瓶颜料。四瓶颜料呢，这个呢是铅丹，这。 这个呢是朱砂，这个呢一般是用于红色，就是相当于我们那边的那个就是变黑的颜色，就是这边变黑呢，主要是铅丹、朱砂和氧化变色。
Quite amazing, because Miss Su is holding two minerals, very rare minerals. They're red, but she talked about when she talked about these minerals, red minerals, she refers to this part, this dark side. So back to 1,000 years ago, or even 1,500 years ago, this part is not black, it is red. 好，继续给我们做个介绍。Another minerals.
对，这个是孔雀石。这个呢是青金石。一个是那个这种绿色，一个是呢蓝色，因为这边的蓝就这种蓝色。对。 这个呢，是我们这三种颜色，是我们克孜尔壁画中非常常见的三种颜色。非常常见的，是不是？对。
I also noticed that in Kizil the Caves there are several important eminent colors. The first one is sort of like the green, and the second one is like blue, and then this part, so it is red actually. 那么这样的一个颜料呢，就是它都是原矿石是吧？对对对。我们都听说这个矿石这种磨制这种粉啊，这种颜料都很贵。你像这样的一小瓶，这么大一点点，它会有多少钱呢？那在您回答之前，我简单跟我们的观众解释一下啊。Ladies and gentlemen, we are doing the live streaming in Kizil Cave Temple Complex in Baicheng County in southern Xinjiang. We came into a very big cave with murals, all kinds of paintings on the walls. It's a really amazing place. And the current time, Ms. Su, the protector of the cultural relics, she's explaining to us what kind of paint the ancient art creators would use on the walls. Let's get back to this part. For example, this part, we see there are typical colors in Kizil Temple. There are three. The first one is green. The second one is blue. The third one is red. Someone would ask me the question, why you would call it red? Because back to the 1,000 years ago, it is red. But after years of changes and decays, it has turned into the black one. So that is really, really amazing and the rare knowledge I know about. Thank you very much for showing us this part. 非常感谢您给我们介绍这一部分。谢谢您，苏老师。谢谢您，苏老师。好，那我们就出来吧。So now we will go outside this cave.
我可以下去了吗？
Take a deep breath. It is very narrow inside this cave, but it is really amazing. 那里边呢，的确是非常的那个狭小，但是里边真的是非常的壮观。那我们想了解一下，在克孜尔这个地方，像这样的一个洞穴的这种保护工作是从什么时候开始的呢 ？So we want to know, when did the conservation and protecting work started here?
应该说，主要是从新中国建立以后吧。首先是成立了就是对它管理的这样一个文管所机构。主要就是成立专门就是有专门的人保护这保卫这里。使它呢不再受这种人为的呀。就是破坏。
Okay, so please. So after the founding of People's Republic China in 1949, a certain organization was established here in Kizil to protect the cultural relics. So take a look from this part into the distance. This whole area, this big area, altogether 349 caves, 总共有349个这个洞窟啊。像您，像刚刚我们见到这位苏老师啊，你们在这里面的工作多少年了？
我工作23年。
苏老师，加入我们啊！好，我们就站这地方啊。So you've been working here for 23 years. Well, this place is really quiet and even isolated from other places. For example, the Kizil City, the Baicheng County is quite far away from that place. How can you do that? 就是那您为什么在23年当中的话都选择留在这个地方呢？您说一下自己的理由。To explain.
我觉得最初来的时候吧，可能只是觉得这一块地方属于这个咱们国家的很重要的一个文化遗产吧。我应该要做一些什么。但是随着工作年限的增长呢，我就觉得它慢慢的成为我生活的一部分。就是说你哪怕你现在肯定就是如果说我非要待在这，我会失去一些东西，我依然会留在这儿。
Well, thank you very much for the explanation for the reason of staying here. He said, 23 years ago, he came here after graduation from college. At that time, he thought it was only the job. But after long years working here, he begins to think this is part of his life. All these grottos, all these murals, caves has become part of his life. So he stays. Even he would lose something, for example, the contacting with prosperity cities, but here is his great cause. 那苏老师，能给我们讲您是来什么时候到这地方来工作的？
我是2016年7月份来这儿的。
那主要从事的工作是怎么样呢 ？She's been here since 2016. She's been here working here for 4 years. 您主要的工作是什么呢？
我是刚来是做那个文物保护修复的，就是做刚才那个壁画修复的。 但是在2019年的时候，就是由于就是工作需要，我现在在做那个工程资料。
Well, at the first three years since the 2016, she's been working as a cultural relics protecting job. At the current time, during the past 1 year, she's been collecting and analyzing all these research data, all the materials.
那我有个简单的问题，就是我们这个保护工作都涉及到什么样的范围？除了我们常规的能知道的，比如说做一些壁画的修复，比如说在这儿设置一些保护措施，还有一些什么样更新的一些措施呢
？What are the latest up-to-date, preservation or the protecting measures you are adopting now in Kizil Cave temples here?
现在呢，就是说呢，比较，我们说呢，把它都叫做预防性保护，就是。一类呢，是因为文物和环境是共存的嘛，环境变化必然引起文物变化，所以呢，你要让文物不发生变化，就控制环境，这是一种办法，所以就是进行环境监测，然后人为的控制环境的各种变化，第二种呢，就是采用数字化的方式，把这些历史信息记录下来，从某种程度上就延续了它的生命。
Okay, there are altogether two ways. I mean, the newest one.Mr. Miao explained to us. The first one, they would use kind of the certain measures to monitor the change of environment, and they would do some kind of precaution job to prevent it from decaying. The second one is digitalizing the images or the murals on the surface of the wall. So these are the jobs they're doing right now.
那么非常感谢你们做了这么多的工作啊，就是在这个地方默默的付出。Thank you very much for the
silent job, the preservation job here. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're doing the live streaming in Kizil Cave Temple in Baicheng County. And now, after the explanation, after the tour is not a viral tour, it's the actual exploration into the caves, all these...remains of Buddhism relics, the cultural relics. We come to the end of this live streaming. So let us thank all those people who silently contributed to the protection of this place. That is because of their job, because it's a hard job. These caves, murals are well preserved. Thank you for watching this live streaming. We'll keep you updated about the other tour in amazing Xinjiang, in other parts of theXinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region, especially the next step, we will go to Abati County in the neighboring Xinhe County. This is also part of the ancient Chuzi State.